Published 0420, EDT, the 30th of October 2017. Updated 0421, EDT, the 30th of October 2017. Terrie MacDonald pictured was terrorised at knifepoint by her drunken mother after she decided to move out the family home. A teenage Manchester City football coach was terrorised at knifepoint by her drunken mother during an explosive row about her moving out of the family home. Terrie MacDonald, 18, was collecting her belongings when she was confronted by her mother, Kelly Dunning, 35, who had just returned from an afternoon drinking. During the argument, mother after Dunning told Miss MacDonald, "This is how you want it, this is how we play it," before cutting up her daughter's clothing with a kitchen knife. She also called the teenager a SLG, SLT and a dog before adding, "Get the F out of my house." Police were called when Dunning's rampage spilled outside, during which she threw a knife at a passing car, shouting at the driver, "Don't you think dare get involved, drive on." In a statement, Miss MacDonald, who joined City in 2016 under a sports coaching apprenticeship with the Premier League club City in the community program, said she wanted Dunning to get help but was sick of her mother's behavior and how she treated her. She added, "I was unable to live life PC and get on with my life. When I was coaching, I was petrified of going home." At Minchell Street Crown Court, Manchester, Dunning, from Stockport, sobbed as she admitted possessing an offensive weapon, threatening a person with a bladed article and criminal damage. She was given an 18-month jail term, suspended for 2 years, and was ordered to complete a 9-month alcohol treatment program. Miss MacDonald, pictured with Rio Ferdinand, joined City in 2016 under a sports coaching apprenticeship with the Premier League club City in the community program. At court, heard Dunning had pushed her daughter to breaking point after she began drinking heavily following the death of her mother in March this year. She had started to drink 2 bottles of a wine a day, the court heard. Nicola Wells, prosecuting, said the relationship between the defendant and complainant deteriorated. The defendant drank regularly and argued with her daughter over petty things and started to become violent. The complainant went away for a few days with friends and returned home on August 28 this year at 8:20 p.m. and decided that she wanted to move out of the family home because of her mother's behavior. Her mother was aware of her daughter's plan to move out because they had discussed it on the phone the night before. Initially, the complainant returned home and began packing when the defendant wasn't home. The defendant arrived home clearly intoxicated. She sat on the doorstep of the property. Dunning pictured drank regularly and argued with her daughter over petty things and started to become violent. The court heard how Dunning cut up her daughter's clothes with a kitchen knife during the explosive row at the family home. The complainant was petrified that she was going to be confronted over moving out. She attempted to sneak out of the back of the property to avoid a confrontation. However, the defendant realized what was happening and went to prevent her daughter from leaving the premises. The complainant was terrified about how the defendant was going to react. The defendant became angry and told her to get the FK out of her house. The complainant was really scared by this point, and the defendant called her sly and a two-faced BTCH. This upset her daughter and she attempted to leave the property and left the bags with her clothes in to prevent it making any worse. The defendant then picked up the bags of her clothes and threw them in the road. The defendant continued to verbally abuse her, saying SLG, SUT and dog. She came towards her and thought that her mother was going to assault her, so she held her arms to prevent her from assaulting her. Dunning admitted most of the wrongdoing but denied having 2 knives and told officers she would have never used them to hurt her daughter. Dunning then returned to the house and came out with a kitchen knife with a 6-inch blade. She then began cutting her daughter's clothes with the knife. Ms. Wells said she was in the road at the time and vehicles were not able to get past. One of the vehicles stopped and she threw the knife at the car. The defendant then went back into the house and returned to the road with a larger knife with a 9-inch blade. Ms. Wells said she threatened the driver of the vehicle and told him, "Don't you fking dare get involved, drive on." The driver did drive on. The neighbors heard the disturbance and provided statements. After the knife had been thrown at the vehicle, the defendant continued to cut up her daughter's clothes with the knife. Neighbors rang the police and when they arrived, they arrested the defendant and confiscated the knives. Dunning, a mother of two, was given an 18-month jail term, suspended for 2 years, and was ordered to complete a 9-month alcohol treatment program. In her police interview, Dunning admitted most of the wrongdoing but denied having two knives and told officers she would have never used them to hurt her daughter. Joe Rawlins, defending, said today she appears as quite a different person and sober. The death of her parents seems to have made her life spiral out of control, and she consumed alcohol as a way out of her problems. She buried her head in the sand. She needs some support. Sentencing, the judge, Mr. Recorder Kieran Rankin, told Dunning, due to your behavior, she concluded that she wanted to move out. Wanting to avoid confrontation, she attempted to get out of the rear of the property. You were verbally abusive and began cutting her clothes up, which was a purely vindictive thing for you to do. You then threw a knife at a vehicle, and after returning into the house to pick up a second knife, you threatened the driver and carried on what you were doing. It is not surprising that the police were called, as a number of people saw your behavior, but when you were arrested, you admitted in the main what you had done. I accept that alcohol has been a continuing problem for you for a number of years. You have had a chaotic few months and you have drunk to excess. Dunning was also issued with a 5-year criminal behavior order preventing her from having more than two visitors at one time at her home. She was also given a restraining order banning her from approaching three of her neighbors. Miss MacDonald, 18, was collecting her belongings when she was confronted by her mother, Kelly Dunning, 35, who had just returned from an afternoon drinking.